All right, check it out. Everybody over here, I want y'all to say just a little bit when I put my hand out like that. Say just a little bit. All right, see, now y'all sound, it's like 40 of y'all, and y'all sound like three people. We need y'all to sound like 400, all right?
Just a little bit.
All right, check it out. Everybody over here, say revolution, like that.
Revolution.
And see, they far away. And see, all right?
Just a little bit.
All right. All right, right, everybody right here, I just want y'all to say yeah, like that. Say yeah.
Yeah.
See, now that's ridiculous, right? All right, like this.
Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Revolution. Yeah! Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Revolution. Yeah!
See? Half them poets, politicians. They ain't got no conviction. They ain't got no predisposition. Their only revolutionary position is exactly to become self-crafted caricatures of the popular expectations of a revolutionary. And if you hit half the male revolutionary poets hard enough in their chest, they'll give you whatever they have on their person for free. So how am I expected to believe that this same individual is capable of stopping a ruthless metropolis from neo-colonizing a community, much less a country? They don't want me to speak on government. Anytime I slide to the mic and start marbles or morally bankrupt them, punk propaganda poets should be loving it. They ain't got no covenant. It's just the bullshit they're full with, regurgitating impragmatic rhetoric all over the pulpit. Child, you got revolution backwards, and I can't wait for the day that they begin to litigate poets for revolutionary malpractice. Bankrupt all y'all fake revolutionary asses for dressing the part but just being actors. You can't completely open your third eye long as you afraid to die, using your poems to talk down about other people's 9-to-5s, when they're doing whatever they have to do to keep their family alive, knowing good and well your ass is scared to hustle to survive. You'll never understand the extent to which this world ain't no joke, and you ain't down and out just because you fell out with your folks. And as long as them cats are still middle class, then your ass ain't never really broke, so I suggest you reconsider that impractical diatribe before it exits your throat for some single mother step up on stage and smack the shit out of you because she relied on some bullshit that you wrote. Well, her kids about to beat your ass with their toys and ready to slit your throat and leave you for dead, soaked to the bone in your own Malcolm X misquotes. You see, the words of a revolutionary have a fiduciary relationship with his or her actions. And whether you're talking male-female relationships or politics, you just better mean that shit like George Jackson, showing Angela Davis why he needed her to feel him, establishing a relationship with his brother Jonathan that epitomized real men. And even now in this new millennium when chances for young black men are still slim, we gotta give it to him for putting so much fear in the heart of the system that even in prison, they saw no other alternative but to kill him. But today's poets are indifferent to this world's capacity for ignorance. They rather gossip about how we pimping this with CDs, like we ain't supposed to see G's, like we supposed to take these degrees and work for some other man and be pleased and wait for him to have some J-O-B freeze and get us out on the line for free cheese and watch our wives and girlfriends leave and have our kids bouncing up on some big Willie's knees. Nah, see? That's why them Black Panthers took off. They got them corporate jobs and wiped that black power look off. And if you talk to them today about revolution, there's a 99% chance that they will attempt to hook off. Because they too had revolution backwards. Not that they were all actors, but their mathematics was inaccurate. You see, sharing cannot exist amongst greed, and socialists don't succeed amongst capitalists. Now, this is a little different than that spill with the cosmetic locks and fatigues and other popular hypocrisies that make mockeries of revolution by improperly introducing a cacophony of confusion. It's not for we to be abusing, using false prophecy and illusion like y'all do it to them. Like fake revolutionary poets come up in here to tell the truth, and there's something about your ear holes that seduce them. There's something about your ear holes that make them bodies shake. Like there's something about your ear holes that make them arms vibrate. Like there's something about your ear holes that make them fingers gesticulate. Like there's something about your ear holes that make them verbally masturbate. Like there's something about your ear holes that make them prematurely ejaculate into your soul. They're fake. Revolution.
Just a little bit. Revolution. Yeah!
Thank you. Let's go.